What's going on? This is Brandon with Pence PC. Today, I'm going to experiment with a new adapter that was recently released that's going to allow you to use a variety of different wireless controllers on your Xbox Original or Original Xbox. This is a huge advantage because just recently I've been playing a little bit on Insignia, which is the revival of the original Xbox Live, and I've noticed that the Xbox controller S is a little dated. The sticks don't feel that great, they're a little rusty, and being able to use a modern-day controller on the original Xbox would be a huge advantage, especially doing it wirelessly. And that is where this comes in, the Brook Wingman Converter XB2. It just came out, and I'm going to test a variety of different controllers and see how well they hold up. So here are all the different controllers I'm going to test today. We have the PlayStation 5, the Xbox One Series X, the original Xbox One that came out with the system back in 2013, a PlayStation 4, PlayStation 3, and Xbox Elite Series 2. Now, this doesn't only work on the original Xbox. Supposedly, this adapter will allow you to use any of these controllers on Xbox Series X/S, Xbox One, Xbox 360, and, of course, the original Xbox. So let's go ahead and get started. So let's go ahead and see what's in the package. Here's the adapter, quite small. It's got some clear buttons on the side. Those are the buttons to sync your controller if you're doing it wirelessly. If you're going to be using this on an original Xbox, you have to have a controller to USB adapter. Now, I sell these on my site that comes with an actual flash drive so you can modify your Xbox. So visit PencePC.com. Link is in the video description to pick up one of these if you need them. So I'm going to go ahead and plug this into my first controller port and then plug in the adapter. I'm going to test the Elite Series 2 controller first. You see the flashing light here on the adapter? I'm going to go ahead and hold it, and it's going to flash a lot faster. And now I'm going to press the sync button on this controller. Now they're synced up. I actually held in my sync button, held it in for about 2 seconds, and then this flashed even faster. So now they're synced up. All right, going back to the Xbox. I have it wirelessly here, and as you can tell, I am moving the games right now. And by the way, if you want to get your Xbox set up like this, you can actually buy a soft mod pack for me that has the hard drive, and it takes only 10 minutes to get it set up like this. Now, so I'm going to try Tony Hawk 3 because I feel like this is the perfect game for being able to tell if there's any input lag whatsoever, because I'm not going to be able to make the tricks that I need to. So let's give it a shot and see. So far, everything feels super fluid. I don't see any issues whatsoever. Let's see if I can get the stat point here. Got it. Oh, where's the S? Where's the S at? There she is. So the first run on Tony Hawk felt really good. I'll go ahead and give another shot for a game. Ah. See, right there, I was holding A and he just popped up. So that is just a slight, there it is again, an issue. I'm holding the A button and he's popping up, meaning it's registering that I'm letting go of the A button. So that is a slight issue there, especially with a game like this. All right, on to the next controller. So it turns out the original Xbox One controller, the one that launched back in 2013, doesn't have Bluetooth. So this can't be connected wirelessly, but I did connect it with a wire and it did work just as well as the Elite Series 2. So unfortunately, this version cannot be connected wirelessly. Not a huge deal, because probably very few people actually use this type of controller, because it's kind of trash. Now I'm going to test the Xbox Series X controller. This is the controller that comes with any Xbox Series X or S console that is sold nowadays, or you can buy it separately, of course, but this is like the newest version. So let's give this a shot. Right now I'm going to go ahead and sync it wirelessly by holding the sync button for 2 seconds, then holding the blue flashing button, so now they're flashing pretty fast. Hopefully they'll sync up pretty easily. And just like that, they're synced up, and the controller rumbled too, letting me know that it's synced. So far, so good. I don't see any issue whatsoever. Let's give the PS4 controller a shot and see. Plugging it in now. So I've got it connected by wire right now. And it is connected. So if I unplug it, it should connect automatically, I would think. Yep. So all the PlayStation controller takes is to connect it by wire first. and then press the on button, and it's connected. So that's pretty cool. You don't actually have to press the sync button or anything. Playing an original Xbox wirelessly with a PlayStation 4 controller. Feels excellent. It really does. I am super impressed with this adapter. Now before, with like the Cronus Max and other things, it was kind of an issue. You had to connect it to your computer, do certain profiles, and that was, you know, years ago, so they might have changed that too, but man, this is great. This is awesome. Being able to use a modern controller on an original Xbox. I'll tell you what, I'm an Xbox controller fanboy, but using the PS4 controller on this game feels pretty good. I wonder what the back and black buttons are on this. It would be probably R1? Yeah. No issues whatsoever with the PS4 controller. It was actually easier to connect than the Xbox controllers. Let's give the PS3 a shot. Same situation. Got the PlayStation 3 controller here connected by a cord, and it's a little dirty. I haven't used this thing in forever. It's a little dusty, but let's plug it in right now and give it a shot. Hopefully it'll be just as easy as the PS4. It looks like it's connected already. Yes, it is. All right, so hopefully if I unplug it, it'll be connected wirelessly. So looking at the PlayStation 3 controller, I connected it via wire and it works great. Unfortunately, I've got 3 different PlayStation 3 controllers and none of them will hold the charge. So I think the batteries are just bad in them. I haven't used these in, shoot, probably 10 years. So that could be the issue. I'm not sure why they are not charging, but maybe the PlayStation controllers have those issues, but I've never really looked into it. So unfortunately, I can only test the wired ability of the PlayStation 3 controller, but it works great. All right, time to try the PlayStation 5 controller. Let's give this a shot. So I'll plug it in with a cord first. Looks like it's connected. Let's see. Yep, it's connected. All right, I'm going to see if I can connect it wirelessly now. So hopefully if I unplug it, it'll just stay connected. Yep, it did. So I had it connected by a cord, unplugged it, then pressed the power on button, and we're connected wirelessly. As easy as that. I'm going to hold down the A button, see if Tony Hawk pops up at all. So I spent 2 minutes holding the X button on the PlayStation 5 controller, and he did not pop up at all. So it was a direct connection the whole time wirelessly, didn't lose any signal whatsoever. I'm very impressed with this product. It's been awesome so far. I figured why not, I have it on hand, I'm going to test an Xbox 360 controller. My cousin still uses a wired Xbox 360 controller for all of his PC games, so hey, there's people still out there, and let's give it a shot. Unfortunately, you can't connect the Xbox 360 controller wirelessly because it doesn't use Bluetooth, but using a wired connection works perfectly fine. And just like all the other controllers, this is perfect. You literally could not ask for anything better. I feel no input lag whatsoever. The 360 controller feels so much better than the original Xbox controller too. So you've got so many different options, all the newest controllers, all the old stuff too. Whatever you want, it works. So as you can see from the video, it worked perfectly, almost flawlessly with every single controller. The only issue that I actually chalk up to my controller itself is the Elite Series 2, just because that controller is known to have a lot of issues, and I think it was just because of that, the button not sticking, button not registering. Is due to the Elite Series 2. Now, the range is excellent too. I am currently downstairs. I went upstairs with the Xbox controller connected, and I did a certain button combination to reset the Xbox, and it worked on the first try. So the range is awesome too, even going through a whole floor. I have seen people online actually connecting 4 of these together, and it seems like they didn't have any issues either. So I had no disconnects while I was playing either. Every other controller worked perfectly. I literally could not ask for anything better than this. The Brook Wingman Converter XB2. Awesome device, quite cheap. I paid $45. It's not too bad for a device that has no issues whatsoever. It's plug and play. You can't ask for anything better. And just remember, this isn't just for the original Xbox. This can be used on the Xbox Series X/S, the Xbox One, Xbox 360, and Xbox Original. So you can use PlayStation controllers on all those Xbox devices, or higher, better Xbox controllers on older Xbox consoles. So a phenomenal device if you want to use a modern day controller on an older console. give it a shot. Be sure to subscribe to the Pence PC YouTube page to see more tutorials, reviews, or firsthand experiences like this. I appreciate it so much.